My name is Marcel Swietering and I'm professor of food microbiology at Wageningen University and member of the ICMSF since 2005. In this clip, I will illustrate the difference between the geometric and the arithmetic mean. Microbial contaminations are often log normally distributed, and this means that if we plot the probability distribution of the log of the microbial concentrations, we get the expected bell-shaped curve of the normal distribution. This is convenient for statistical treatment and representation of the data. The concentration at the peak of the curve is called the geometric mean concentration. This is, however, not the mean of the concentrations on the normal linear scale, since that mean is influenced more by the higher values of the right-hand tail of the distribution. The average of the linear scale is called the arithmetic mean. This can be further understood if we plot the log normal distribution with the x-axis on the linear scale. Then we see that without this log transformation, the distribution is having a long right-hand tail, and we see that the geometric mean is far left in the curve. The arithmetic mean, the real average of the numbers, is much more to the right, being more influenced by the right-hand tail. On which scale do we have to reason now? On the log scale or on the linear scale? My answer would be, use them both. Because for microbial analysis of the data and for statistical analysis and for representation of the data, best is to use the log transformations. Since then we get a normal distribution and this is more handy to treat, interpret and visualize. For the impact of the distribution, however, the arithmetic value on or the linear scale is more relevant. We can illustrate this with a simplified example. Let's assume that you have to consume 3 products. And you can choose the products in row 1, in row 2 or in row 3. Which 3 would you consume? If you would consume the 3 products in row 1, you would ingest 300 bacilli. For row 2, 1,110 and for row 3, 10,101. So I would take the products in row 1. The total exposure is lower. Now, if we would first log transform these data, we get for the first row 2, 2 and 2. And for the second row 1, 2 and 3. And for the third row 0, 2 and 4. All these 3 rows on the log scale have as average 2. The geometric mean of all these 3 rows is 100, so 10 to the power 2. So the log geometric mean is 2. For all the 3 cases. So this is not a good indicator of the real exposure. Now let's calculate the average on the linear scale. For the first row it's easy, 3 times 100 has its average 100. For the second row we get 1,110 divided by 3, which is 370. And for the third row it's 10,101 divided by 3, which is 3,367. So the arithmetic means are clearly different, as is also the log arithmetic mean, as is also the exposure. The arithmetic mean is therefore a better descriptor for the exposure, while the geometric mean is better for the statistical description of the concentration distribution. If we describe the microbial concentration on a log scale, we get the normal distribution and the peak of this distribution shows the geometric mean. In this graph, 3 is the log 10 of the geometric mean of the counts. It is also the arithmetic mean of the log 10 counts. But if we then investigate this on a linear scale, we see that the geometric mean of the counts at the peak of the distribution is very low on the linear scale and underestimates largely the real average counts. The real average of the counts is much more determined by the tail of the curve and is here indicated as the arithmetic mean of the counts. The arithmetic mean can also be calculated from the geometric mean with the equation presented here. If the standard deviation is 0, so when there is no variation, they are both equal. But the bigger the standard deviation, the more the arithmetic mean is larger than the geometric mean. You can also look up the FAO-WHO guideline on statistical aspects of microbiological criteria for further information. Note that the ICMSF spreadsheet programmed in Excel includes support for these aspects. The concentration distribution is shown on log scale, and the mean and the standard deviation of this log normal distribution are inputs. The operating characteristic curve on the other end is presented with the log arithmetic mean of the concentrations. and the performance of the sampling plan is described with both arithmetic and geometric values to support the user. Distributions are relevant for the performance of sampling plans. To describe these distributions, the log normal distribution is often preferred. To describe the performance for public health impact and risk management, the arithmetic mean is more relevant than the geometric mean. Tools to support these calculations do exist, like for example the ICMSF spreadsheet.